Hallelujah upon you, my dear students. For you all are OL by the grace of Allah. I am also OL. I am also very OL. Hope you have seen the last class taken by me. The last class was on the importance of learning vocabulary. You have also known that without vocabulary you cannot learn English well, and that may be English first paper and maybe English second paper. Without learning vocabulary you cannot do well in English. Never you can do this. Today I will go into the depth of the first paper, the first passage of the text, Unforgettable History. The Unforgettable History, and the topic of this text is the historic 7th Mars speech delivered by Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. However, this is Sheikh Ramzan Ali, lecturer in English, Kalukhani Mira College. You all are welcome to online class, Kalukhani Mira College, Kalukhani Rajbar. I will try to discuss today the Unforgettable History, the first passage of your English first paper textbook. This is just the throughout the thorough speech of Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, the founding father of the nation. I will not be able to discuss or translate all the passages, the complete passages. I will just try to emphasize the importance of the historic speech. Because if you don't understand the importance of the speech, you will not be interested to read this passage or the speech. The speech, you know, that is an important speech and is an is a famous speech throughout the world. And you also know that this speech has been included by the UNESCO as a documentary heritage in 2017. This speech was delivered at the Race Course Maidan in the then East Pakistan. This speech was so fervent and so important that by this speech many, many people and including youth, women and old people, many, many people were inspired by this speech, and at a stage they joined the war in 1971, and after a long 9-month war they won the war. And it will not be exaggeration that the win in the war was a result of the speech. By being inspired by this speech, the common people joined the war, and at a stage they win the war. If you deeply study the speech, or if you deeply and attentively listen to the speech, that the speech was so important and significant that you also can be motivated and inspired by this speech. As this speech has been included in your textbook, you should study this speech very seriously and very attentively. And you should study this speech in English language, and you should study this speech, and you will have to give it an importance or emphasize every word or every phrase of this speech. And at this stage, I want to say that you will get 3 passages in your questions in first paper. 3 passages. The first passage, under the first passage, you will have two questions. And number one A, you will have to answer the multiple choice question. Under this question, you will get 5 marks. And number one B, you will have to answer 5 questions A, B, C, D, E in this way. And every question cover 2 marks, and 5 questions will cover 10 marks. That means under the first passage, you will get 15 marks. And the second passage, under the second passage, you will get 10 marks, and that will filling in the table with information from the text. And the third passage you will get, and under the third passage you will have to write the summary of the passage. That is that will be on summarizing the passage. However, I will try to discuss today about the first passage from the text, and that is the whole or complete speech delivered by Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, the founding father of the nation of Bangladesh. If you read or study or listen to the full speech of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, you will know that how important the speech is. Even today, many more students, intellectuals, and common people are getting inspiration and is being patriots by being by reading the by studying the speech or listening to the speech. So we should study the passage very attentively. If we very seriously or attentively study the passage, we will be able to understand the importance of this passage, and in the same way we will be able to answer the questions very well. And to answer the questions very well, you should study the passage very attentively and with full concentration. And if you will be able to do this, you will be able to answer the questions very well. And for this, you will have to study the speech, every word for word, every phrase. And you will find some idiom, you will find some unknown words, and you should know the unknown words, you should know the meaning of the unknown words, and with the unknown words, you should know at least one synonym or antonym, because you will find this item, synonym or antonym, in your second part. In your second paper, in your second paper, you will get a topic, synonym or antonym. So you should study the passage very sincerely and to answer the questions very well. And today my class is to be ended here, and I want to say that you will follow our online class, and the next class will be on how to answer the questions number 1 and 2 from the passage. If you see the next class, and that will be on the passage, and I will try to make it clear or make it easier how to answer the questions number 1 A and B. And thank you, my students.